This week on Maker Update, an infinity of infinities, lasers and rockets for cats, and a giant skeleton made of chicken wire. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update. I hope you're doing well. We're counting down to Halloween over here, and I hope you're feeling the spirit too. I've got a great show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. Check out this interactive mechanical infinity mirror table by DavidHuangLab. Here's a project that really is stunning both technically and artistically. The basic idea here is that you have a two-way mirror glass table that is nested with a series of illuminated two-way mirror boxes. When a hand is placed on the table, the position of the hand is detected and the closest box is lit up and begins to pull away from the surface of the table. This same action cascades across the other boxes, then slowly, they all return to the surface. But what makes the effect so mind-melting is that as the boxes pull away from the surface of the table, you're playing with the gap between the light ring and the reflecting surfaces. So not only do you get this infinity view, but you get this smooth effect of infinity stretching out and then compressing back. And that's just the top view. With the side open, you can see the effect reaching out in both directions, and it looks like you're on the set of some million-dollar Beyoncé music video. You also get a peek at how it's all working. Mounted to a structure of aluminum channel, you have a series of linear actuators that move the boxes up and down like little elevators. These actuators are created using a combination of stepper motors and lead screws, which is what gives it such a CNC-like accuracy and smooth acceleration curve. Networking all these motors together is a real challenge. He seems to be using a system called EtherCAT to address the problem, but it's still an intimidating amount of wiring. And I say seems to be because it's worth mentioning that this video is all in what Google tells me is Taiwanese. It's a testament to David's video, though, that I can still grasp most of what's going on here. From designing the boxes, laser cutting them, lighting them up, creating the main enclosure, working out how to do touch detection on the top surface, all of it is there to learn from, even if you don't understand what's being said. More projects. For a mini light show that you can probably build in a day, check out Gatoino by Small Batch Factory. This is an open source, Arduino-powered, automatic laser pointer toy to keep your cat entertained. The idea is that you put it on a shelf or mount it to your wall, and a system of servo-controlled mirrors reflects the laser diode around your floor. There's an interface and OLED screen for switching between different settings, and because it's all open source, you can customize the code and options all you want. Speaking of high-quality cat entertainment, don't miss this new video from Wesley Treat on how he made this multi-level cat condo inspired by a rocket playground structure he played on as a kid. This thing is awesome. And if you're inspired to make something like it, the elements here seem to be pretty straightforward. Plywood, aluminum, some carpeting, and a 3D printed nose cone. If your cat's a climber, this is a pretty swanky alternative to one of those boxy towers. Plus, now that we know about Gatoino, you can outdo Wesley by putting lasers on top. Over on her channel, Ali Spagnola shows how she made this giant glowing ghost skeleton by making a chicken wire copy of her Home Depot skeleton. It's a cool idea. Ali had seen work on smaller projects, but at a scale this huge, it took a long, long time. The sharp ends of the chicken wire are also brutal on your fingers. Still, there are some great tips in this video on working with wire, molding it, cutting it, and repairing it. On a smaller scale, it could be great for getting a new Halloween decoration together in the next couple weeks. For another tip on taking your Halloween decorations up a notch, check out Erin St. Blaine's guide on Adafruit for hacking a fog machine for motion activation. A fog machine is an essential element for creating a spooky environment, but if you keep that thing running all the time, you're just wasting fog. Erin shows how even a basic fog machine can be adapted with a microcontroller and motion sensor so that it activates only when people are nearby. If your object detection needs are a little more specific, you may want to check out the official Raspberry Pi AI camera module. Built around a Sony IMX500 intelligent vision sensor, the module has enough computing power and memory to perform real-time object detection, segmentation, and pose estimation without leaning on the Raspberry Pi for processing. It's available now for $70, and you can find a DigiKey product link down in the description. Also available now, friend of the show, Ryan Jenkins from Wonderful Idea Company has a new book out called The Tinkering Workshop. For years now, Ryan has been developing fun and easy ways for kids to experiment, build, and invent things. Now he's compiled all those STEAM projects and building blocks into a book. If you're a parent or an educator, I highly recommend checking it out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, last year, Becky Stern put out a great video on light-up Halloween costume ideas that use NeoPixels. These LEDs may seem commonplace to us, but they make a big impact, especially when they're integrated into a costume design. And that big impact can do a lot of the work for you in achieving a memorable costume. Becky's cardboard UFO here is a great example. It's the LEDs that sell it. So check out the video down in the description for tons of tips and ideas. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible. Thanks to TMDC Workshop in Barcelona for the use of their space. And thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.